So this is kind of a, it's our opera workshop. We have a bunch of people that came together about 6 weeks ago. We put them all together. We have some duets and trios and stuff that's happening. But I think it's like musical theater. If you see something that you like, what do you do? And some people go, woo-hoo! So now, what if you see something that's really sad? What do you do? Aww. Can I hear that? Aww. Now, what if you see something that's really funny? Oh, but this is Italian opera, isn't it?
It's Italian.
So we have special Italian words. You've probably seen this in opera, but when a guy sings, you say bravo. So can I hear you guys go bravo?
Bravo.
Now, they like to hear it really loud. Can you try it one more time?
Bravo.
Now, what about when a girl sings?
Brava. Brava.
Now, what if a bunch of people sing?
Bravi.
Somebody said
bravi. Ooh, they're smart.
Now, you might also see something that's really cool, and people are going to say, ooh. So feel free to do that.
So we love having audience participation in our shows, so feel free to make a lot of noise. But in Italian, right, Jeff?
In Italian.
In Italian.
And I think a ooh is Italian, too.
Absolutely.
Can you guys go, ooh?
Ooh.
See, it's Italian.
That's
okay.
Italian.
Should we get on with our show?
Okay, let's get on with our show.
Benita Menda. Gentlemen, my name is Jeffrey Stevens, and I'm the baritone of this opera group. The baritone gets to play a lot of really cool parts, like old guys and funny guys, but my favorite part of all is the bad guy.
Ooh.
Oh, one thing I forgot to tell you about opera, people die. But throughout the evening, you'll hear these cool people sing. Now, I'll show you who are the sopranos.
Woo!
They sound nice, don't they? Then we have the mezzos. So those are sometimes called altos, witches, britches, and bad women. Then we have the tenors. Those are the tenors. They play the love interest, and they usually get the girl. Then we have a bad guy, a couple of bad guys. They're the basses and the baritones.
Yeah.
And I think we have a trolloper too.
Yeah.
So the first aria that we're going to present, I think might be familiar to you. It's called Un mio bambino caro, and it's from Johnny Schicchi by Puccini. This aria has been in quite a few commercials, like Honda, and even an Alexa commercial. So, Alexa, play Puccini. And so we don't have Alexa. But we do have Clara and Amanda. So, Clara and Amanda, play Puccini, please.
Formaggio,
formaggio.
you'll hear him sing an evil song later. Finally, we have mezzo from Carmen, Carmen herself, sung by Janine Bonine. The mezzos in French music are so sexy.
La Cinderella!
Woohoo!
So next, one composer that we think of, I don't know, I think about when I think about an opera is Mozart. We have a couple of operas that we'd like to feature. The first one is Così fan tutte, which means women are like that. The show starts off with Ferrando, Joe, and Guglielmo, Ben, expressing certainty that their lovers, the sisters, Dorabella Mackenzie and Fiordaligi, Sheila, will remain faithful forever. Don Alfonso, Bob, bets them that they won't. The boys pretend to go off to war and then come back and appear in the scene as two Albanians and are introduced to the sisters. But at this point, the sisters say, "No way! We love our guys too much. Let's see what happens."
I present Miss Despinetta, a discreet and charming person. There is no one who knows better how to help you reach your goal. Remember, I'll see you later.
Thank you.
crazy.
Hey, now, this opera, since you're the resident soprano and you die most of the time,
yes,
so does this opera have dying?
Well, that's a comic opera, so there's lots of fun stuff and shenanigans in a comic
opera. Oh, so Mozart. So Mozart does have comic operas.
Lots of comic operas.
In fact, we have two scenes coming up from Magic Flute. Have you guys heard of the Magic Flute?
Yes.
And the Arizona
Queen of the Night, right?
Queen of the Night. Yeah. Yes. Arizona Opera is doing it this next year, so we thought we'd show it off a little bit first. So in this neck, we have two scenes from Magic Flute. In the first one, we have Tamino, Zach, is being chased by a monster. This show has a monster. His name is Ben. The three ladies, played by Amanda, Katarina, and Allison, the attendants of the Queen of the Night, save him. Oh, let's see what's happening.
Thank you.
insane dream of my life. Saw a monster come to attack me and these three angels came.
So, the monster didn't even die. Nobody dies.
Nobody died in that one. No.
So then we have this next part, we have Papageno. And I think Zach, are you playing Papageno? Oh, Zach is back playing Papageno. He's playing two different characters. So let's give him a hand. Zach's 18 years old, and Zach sort of sounds like a tenor, and his grandfather, Mark Denton, said he was a tenor, but then we thought, oh, you know, he sounds like a baritone, too. So Papageno is a baritone in this opera, and Domino is a tenor. Like a boat? So we'll see what happens. Anyway, so Papageno starts at the very beginning of the opera, and his one thing, he wants to find a girlfriend. That's all he wants, through the whole thing, and he's but.
Oh.
Don't cry then. So, but then at the end of the opera, he is so sad because he's seen Papageno once before, but he wants to find his girlfriend. Okay, now. So he's depressed, he's about to hang himself, and then he goes and she appears.
Now you will be mine forever.
Now you will be mine forever.
Come and see my little starling.
My
little starling, my little starling. What a joy for us is near.
What a joy for us is near.
When the gods their bounty showing. On us bestowing, and their grace on us bestowing, will send us tiny children dear, children dear, children dear, children dear, such lovely tiny children dear, such lovely tiny children dear. First we will have a Papageno,
then we will have a Papageno,
then comes another Papageno,
then comes another Papageno,
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 Papageno, Papageno. Upon their parents blessings bring, but the greatest joy of any,
it is the greatest joy of any,
when many men.
Papageno scores! So I forgot to mention, that was Sydney playing Papageno. Let's give her a hand. Take you to a little operetta called Der Vogelhändler, and we see Crystal Stacy. She's out delivering mail, and she may just have some mail for you. Thank you.
liegt auf der Stelle, denn bei der Post geht's nicht so schnell.
In Wukifet from Faust. He teases, don't open the door or even give a kiss until you get a ring on your finger. Manon by Massenet. Manon is a classic struggle of the soprano Jenny, deciding between riches of true love. In this aria, she is saying goodbye to her true love before she goes off for another, for a life of status and riches. workshop again. With the singers, we are training. You, the audience, will find it entertaining. Ta-ta. Well, ask us if we forgot to sing. We said yes. Okay, so let's get on with this thing.
Yes.
In Lajaconda, we see classic unrequited love, a love triangle of sorts, and self-sacrifice. Lajaconda, the soprano, loves the tenor. The bad bass baritone loves the soprano, and the tenor still loves his ex-girlfriend. Wait, there's more. The bad bass baritone wants to get rid of the tenor so he can have the soprano, and the soprano sacrifices herself so the her love can be his ex-girlfriend, and she doesn't have to be stuck with the bad bass baritone. Are you confused?
Yes.
Me too. That's opera. In this aria, Gioconda contemplates self-sacrifice for the one she loves.
Thank you.
Oh.
He does.
Okay, well, now we're going to have kind of a happy song. Next we have the Barcarolle from the Tales of Hoffman. It's a duet for soprano Clara and mezzo-soprano Janine. It's considered one of the most famous barcarolles ever written. The two sing of the beauty of the night and of love. Charlotte also experiences hopeless love, and in this aria, Charlotte sings to Sophie, her sister, a younger sister, more optimistic sister, telling her that it is sometimes a good thing to grieve and not to be consoled.
Oh.
So this next aria, and next aria is Questo è quello. The Duke of Rigoletto makes his attitude towards women crystal clear. The title roughly translates as this woman or that one. This one is usually sung by most of the famous operetta tenors, so let's hear it, Giuseppe. People made a bunch of noise at the first, and then when he's not singing, you make a bunch of noise, and then when he finishes, you make a bunch of noise. So, can you guys make a bunch of noise? Steamboat that she takes for the journey, and we meet many people on the ship. This scene we are about to see is with Rosalba, Jenny, and Arcadio, Logan, and what seems to be a budding romance. After this, his aria, Logan expresses the passion to fly. Let's hear it.
El sol de África. cuadro de papel.
Es un libro, muy pronto será un libro. Quisiera seguir.
This is a quote from TVTropes.org, talking about the operas. The operas tend to include a number of characters intended to show off what might be called the Savoy's stock company. First, we have a light baritone playing a generally not very pleasant character who wishes, usually without success, to marry the heroine and who will almost certainly at some point sing a patter song. Then we have a soprano heroine, sometimes sympathetic, but often selfish and scheming. We have a pompous bass baritone. Then we have a contralto as the great Anna Russell described her, a voice like a foghorn who attempts to marry a man who desperately does not want to marry her. These are the Gilbert and Sullivan operas. In most operas, the characters have an introduction aria. The Pirates of Penzance, we meet the pirate king, Ben, the pompous bass baritone. Oh, you might remember him from Chandler-Gilbert's The Wedding Singer last fall? Well, here he comes.
Better far to live and die under the brave black flag I fly. Then play a sanctimonious part with a pirate head and a pirate heart. Away to the cheating world go you, where pirates are all well-to-do. But I'll be true to the song I sing and live and die a pirate king. Oh, I am the pirate king. And it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king. I am the pirate king. And it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king.
The pirate king,
hurrah for the pirate king. When I sally forth to seek my prey, I help myself in a royal whale. I sink a few more ships, it's true, than a well-bred monarch ought to do. But many a king on a first-class throne, if he wants to call his crown his own, must somehow manage to get through more dirty work than e'er I do. Oh, I am the pirate king. And it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king. I am the pirate king. And it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king.
Hurrah for the pirate king!
Introduction of a patter baritone Coco, Greg, the Lord High Executioner, and listen carefully, he's going to list a bunch of people who might not be missed. This is followed by three little maids as they introduce themselves, Yum Yum, Peep Bo, and Pity Sing.
Thank you. victim must be found. I've got a little list. I've got a little list of society's offenders who might well be underground and who never would be missed. Oh, who never would be missed. There's the one in every opera course who shows up late to class, but he's the executioner and therefore gets a pass. The disrespectful co-workers who never clean a dish, the microwave left oozing rotting smells of pungent fish. The telephone solicitor who simply won't desist. They'd none of them be missed. They'd none of them be missed.
He's got them on the list. He's got them on the list. And they'd none of them be missed. They'd none of them be missed.
There's the audiences that don't yell bravo, but merely clap. The Pokemon Go-ist, I've got her on the list. The Academy Award host Will Smith greeted with a slap. They'd none of them be missed. Oh, they'd none of them be missed. The friend who says that PDA should always be taboo as he climbs on top his girlfriend like it's springtime at the zoo. The men who think they're clever with the pickup lines they shout, who've never owned a library card and couldn't check you out. The perv you knew in middle school, who someone said you kissed. I don't think he'll be missed. I know he'll not be missed.
He's got them on the list. He's got them on the list. And then none of them be missed.
And the people who think Johnny Depp as Grindelwald was grand. The pirate wasn't missed. I've got them on the list. And the fools who pay for Nickelback or Bieber on demand. They'd none of them be missed. I wish they'd just desist. The judgy aunt or uncle who make every topic tense insults you as they start each sentence with a no offense. The men who haven't learned that toilet seats go up and down. All creepers who have ever wished that they could be a clown. And people who hate opera, I'm sure you get the gist. They'd none of them be missed. Oh, they'd none of them be missed.
He's got them on the list. He's got them on the list. And they'd none of them be missed. And none of them be
soprano, Yum Yum, and when Mezzo the Catashaw, or or Katyshaw, who, once the tenor finds out about his supposed death, she is grief-stricken. Coco, the baritone, persuades Katyshaw, the mezzo, to marry him. Then everybody lives happily ever after. The tenor, soprano, mezzo, and baritone.
Oh, Katyshaw, I dare not hope for your love, but I will not live without it, darling.
You, whose hands still reek from the blood of my betrothed, dare to address words of passion to the woman you have so foully wronged?
I do accept my love, or I perish on the spot.
Go to! Who knows so well as I that no one has ever yet died of a broken heart?
You know not what you say. Listen.
On a tree by a river, a little tom tit, singing willow tit, willow tit, willow. And I said to him, Dickie bird, why do you sit singing willow tit, willow tit, willow? Is it weakness of intellect, birdie, I cried, or a rather tough worm in your little inside? With a shake of his poor little head, he replied, oh, willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. He slapped at his bow as he sat on that bough, singing willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. And a cold perspiration bespangled his brow. Oh, willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. He sobbed and he sighed and a gurgle he gave, and he plunged himself into a billowy wave. And an echo arose from the suicide's grave. Oh, willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. And I feel just as sure as I'm sure that my name isn't willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. That was blighted affection that made him exclaim, oh, willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. And if you remain callous and obdurate, I shall perish as he did, and you shall know why. Though I probably shall not exclaim as I die. Oh, willow, tit, willow, tit, willow.
Did he really die of love?
He really did.
All on account of a cruel little hen?
Yes.
Poor little chap.
It's an affecting tale and quite true.
I knew the bird intimately.
Did you? He must have been very fond of her.
His devotion was something extraordinary.
Oh, poor little chap. And if I refuse you, will you go and do the same?
At once.
No, no, you mustn't anything but that. I'm such a silly goose.
You are.
And you won't hate me if I'm a teeny weeny wee bit bloodthirsty, will you?
Hate you? Oh, Katyshaw. Is there not beauty even in bloodthirstiness?
My idea, exactly. There is beauty in the bellow of the blast. There is grandeur in the growling of the gale. There is eloquent outpouring when the lion is roaring and the tiger is flashing of his tail.
Yes, I'd like to see a tiger from the Congo or the Niger, and especially when lashing of his tail.
Volcanoes have a splendor that is grim, and earthquakes only terrify the dolts. But for those who are scientific, there is nothing that's terrific in the flight of falling, soft-falling thunderbolts.
Yes, in spite of all my meekness, if I have a little weakness, it's a passion for a flight of thunderbolts.
If that is so, sing, derry,
are one. Away we'll go and merrily, merry, nor tardly tarry till day is done. Beauty in extreme old age. Do you fancy you are elderly enough? Information I'm requesting on a subject interesting is a maiden all the better when she's tough.
Throughout this wide dominion, it's a general opinion that she'll last a good deal longer when she's tough.
Are you old enough to marry, do you think?
Oh, yeah.
Won't you wait until you're 80 in the shade? There's a fascination frantic with a ruin that's romantic. Do you think you are sufficiently decayed?
To the matter that you mention, I have given some attention, and I think I am sufficiently decayed.
If that is so, sing dairy down, dairy in seven, and dairy our tastes are one. Away we'll go and merrily, merry, no tardly, dairy till day is done.
Administrative and helpful Irisi Shikawa. couldn't be here because her back is hurting, but she does everything around this place. Give her a hand. Levado, she helped out tonight, so it's it for me. And also our wonderful faculty here at Performing Arts of Chandler-Gilbert for their support. Joey Johnston is back there.
Class, these opportunities don't only are possible because of our amazing faculty that we have, Dr. Cheryl, Dr. Stevens, Professor Nagy. Thank you on behalf of our class. We just want to thank you as well.
Thanks for coming to see our show. We really loved it, and we love these guys, so.
We do. We love these guys very much. So they have one more number for you before you go out.
Amazing, Amanda, good job on the
Thank you for coming to